Hello guys, this is Rahul. Today we're gonna see the first steps to Git. How do we go about using Git? So the first thing we do is download Git first. So just do a Google search, Git download, and that's it. Go to the site. And I'm using Windows right now, so I'll click Windows. And so just download this 32-bit, 64-bit according to just your processor. And this shit is downloading. This is downloading right now. Okay. Alrighty, let's click on it. Just follow the steps. I've already installed it. I'm using the Windows command prompt for now. Okay, just install it and install it itself. Okay, I've already installed it, so after installing it, go to github.com, and create an account there. I've created mine. So we have signed in, and let's create a new repository. Repository is anything anything. It can be anything. Repository can be a folder, the folder may contain anything like Android projects, your web technology files, and everything, and simple text files too, anything. So let's create a new repository. So the repository name, let's name it anything. Den. Let's create, okay, not den, GitHub example, start example. So can make it if you make it private, you have to pay, and if public, it's totally, it's take the next steps, it will be much clearer. So let's just create a repository. Already. Okay. Copy this. Copy. Okay. Just these are the first steps we need to follow while creating a repository. So like So now go back. Just make a directory, any directory. MDM. Let's name it den 2, and let's create a file here and just type. Just save it, close here. Then So now I want to upload this repository to GitHub. This seems pretty simple, but when managing things, when editing, adding more things, in Google Drive, you need to upload everything again and again, the whole project. But in GitHub, we just need to do patches and add the minimum changes that are required to there are revision changes. Okay, so that's the best part of it. You don't need to upload everything again and again, just the things which are added, those we need to upload. All right, so just on your command line, sorry, not on, but go to your command prompt. File is at the folder is at the desktop. Already. So now just we need to follow these commands. these commands. So first we'll follow this command. Echo. This command initializes the it makes the computer know that this is a Git repository. Okay. And this is the add command. It tells the computer this file has been the Git tool, that this file has been added, and it should be considered for uploading to the GitHub. And also we added this next file, the new doc test document, the file we just created, text file we created. Okay, just if you do this, git add dot, it does all the new files for uploading, which are added. Okay, and this is the command which tells the computer that this repository, this file has its origin in the github.com, and it's the same this address which is given here. Okay, and that's all we need. And this commit command is tells the computer that the change is done till now to be finalized and should be uploaded when push command is executed. I'll come to push command first. Let's do this. Yeah, see this. So the next thing, git push. And yeah, it's done. The changes have been forwarded to the site, and see now. See now, the changes have been added. Yeah. So let's do another change and tell you how this affects. Okay. Yeah. This we have added this file. Now see, we don't need to add everything. We just need to perform this, do this commands. Write out this commands. And just perform the push command again. And that's it. These changes will be added directly. And what GitHub does, there are two commits. What GitHub does is keep revisions of your code again and again. See, this is a file. Yeah. This is a second commit. See this. So yeah, that's the good thing about GitHub, Git tool and everything. And that's it. This was the most basic thing. The projects can be of great complexity, and Git is a very good tool in maintaining this project. GitHub is not the only player in this market which uses Git tool. There is also Bitbucket and Microsoft Foundation Server. Check out those two. In Bitbucket, you don't need to pay for private repositories. There's a constraint for the team limit, but you don't need to pay for private repositories. And that is it. And also there is this pull command, which so like there are no changes, like, you know, and no other changes, commits which are not being recorded in this like local repository and remote repository. So like the remote repository and local repository are same, but if the remote repository is two commits ahead of the local repository, like this git pull command, what will do is like pull all the changes and update the local repository true with the remote repository, and that's like. And also there is the clone command, which I will show you. Like let's just change the directory here from here. Okay, like we are in this directory now. Let's clone the repository. Clone is like you know, if you don't have the local repository on your computer right now, you can just download it from the remote repo, like the from the site. See how I do it. I found those URL from here. Clone. Just copy it. Just it happens like it clones the remote repository into your computer, and that's it. That's a clone. And these are the most basic commands which are used right now, like, you know, for any beginner. See, so this was the repository that was cloned, and the same contents in the as in the remote repository. Okay, alrighty.